I'm in Ivanovo, the city out of the western light. And in this video, I'll let you know everything about this city. First of all, I answer two questions. One is how to get here, and the second one, is it worth of doing it? Ivanovo is located 300 kilometers from Moscow, and it will take you 5 hours journey on a train. The city is the capital of the Ivanovo region. To be honest, it's not a very popular tourist destination, but maybe there are some places which we will find out. The city is famous for its constructivism, and there are many interesting facts about that town. Now let's go and start our day with the observation. I have that attraction just in front of me, and I think it's a good start to get known the town.
Один билет, пожалуйста.
250 rubles cost one ride on the, I don't know the English name, observation wheel. I'm gonna do it now. Ivanovo is a relatively young city, it's only 150 years old. It was the most prosperous 100 years ago, in 1920s, 1930s, after the revolution in USSR. Now the population of Ivanovo is declining, and the city was counting as one of the poorest in Russia. In Soviet time, the town Ivanovo was called as the city of brides, because here was coming many women across Russia, because here was many linen factories. It was a good place to find a bride. And another nickname for this city is Russian Manchester, and the reason to call it Russian Manchester is also as the Manchester rich in the industries related to fabric. The city is not quite small, it's 400,000 people, almost half of the million, but the population is declining. Many of the young people going to Moscow or a bigger city like Yaroslavl looking for work. Another interesting thing about Ivanovo is capital of trolley buses. Trolley buses is a mean of public transportation powered by electricity. The central street of Ivanovo has been empty yet, and trolley buses are playing the role of the barriers to block the traffic from the side streets. The whole street is empty, it's because the marathon is happening today on the 1st of May each year in Ivanovo. Runners going across the street, and most likely we will see it because it's gonna happen in just in 5 minutes. I think this is a great solution for recreational purposes, and it's such a good way just to chill and to do some recreation, especially in the summer day. Great way to be and to get, I think this is a great way to
get leisure. I
think here is the first runners, they're probably gonna win, and more are coming, so the marathon is happening now. I don't know who said that young people are leaving Ivanovo. As for now, there are so many young people around me, and I have actually the feeling that city is rather young than old. They wanted to build up the capital of Russia in Ivanovo. This is a very interesting fact. Not Moscow, but Ivanovo, but it didn't happen. During this decade, from 1920s, 1930s, most of the buildings and many factories was built up here, and even just on this street, you can see many buildings dated in 1920s, 1930s. But then when USSR collapsed, the economy went down, and many of the factories which were built in Ivanovo got bankrupt. Another interesting fact that Ivanovo is in the Russian tourist itinerary, very famous Golden Ring, but it's in this itinerary because of the political reasons. The main reason is because Ivanovo played a crucial role in the revolution. Originally, the Golden Ring itinerary was without Ivanovo, just other cities like Kostroma, Yaroslavl, Vladimir, Suzdal. We're gonna visit many of them. But then the Soviet government decided to add Ivanovo into that list. After the USSR collapsed during the Russian time, Ivanovo has lost its title of the city with the historical interest. So that's a bit contradicting, because with one hand Ivanovo is in golden ring still, but on the other hand it's lost its title of the historical town. Most of the cities is not old. You can't really find here Kremlin or other large Orthodox churches. Maybe we'll see some. The streets are wide here and the city is quite spacious. I'm looking forward to explore more of the landmarks. From a cute central part of the town, we're going to the area more residential, more real, more Russian. It's like back in 30 years ago, in 90s of the last century, with markets and bazaars, people selling some stuff, flowers, souvenirs, and etc. Let's go check it out. Fast credits, fast money, fast credits. Get yourself to the that. Let's go and discover the Ivanovo's market. Typical market with clothing for kids, for men, for women, for teenagers. Anything you can get very cheap. Typical market like anywhere in Russia. In a Russian city you'll see something similar. Oh, and we came to the bus station, I think. As the city is quite new, the railway station in this town, it's also new. Some buildings was so beautiful and unusual, but many of them are in the very bad condition. This is the typical Soviet mosaic. And here is another mosaic, the Soviet International Friendship. There you, on the mosaic, you'll see different races and nationalities holding the Soviet flag. And all of a sudden, next to the railway station, the cathedral is rising. It's rather beautiful and I don't think it's actually old. Typical Soviet style hotel. What I like here so is how the shop on the corner designed its exteriors. And the marathon runners are getting faster and faster. And so many young people is probably because today is the runner's day and all the kind of schools and colleges are making little competitions. And here it looks like this was the old train station over here next to that modern one. It looks very cute. First old church which I'm seeing now, and it's unusual because the roof of the church is not colorful or golden, it's black. I rarely saw anything like this in the Orthodox churches. The main religion in Russia is Orthodox Christian, and all across Russia you'll find many churches and we will go to some of them. The traffic is blocked everywhere and it's very quiet and gives to the city the special feeling of tranquility, coming to another beautiful piece of Soviet architecture of brutalism. This is a cinema made from the concrete. The sign on the cinema is old. It's been preserved from the Soviet time. That statue on the top is a statue for the Soviet soldiers who were participating in the Second World War and made Soviet Union win the Nazi Germany. The city of bright Russian Manchester. I'm finishing this journey in Ivanovo, and I would recommend you to come here and to visit, because I don't know any other city where you will see such a Soviet heritage. Hope you're enjoying my channel, guys, and if you do, then please subscribe to it and hit the like button. It's very important to me. It motivates me to film more and it ranks my videos in higher positions in YouTube. And comment which city I should go to next. I read all the comments. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.